So in reality, is it smart to have a home office? Absolutely. Is there a loophole provided for you to take advantage of for your business? Absolutely. So why wouldn't you take advantage of this? So a lot of times, remember, when you're in real estate, you're an independent contractor, you are working with and for a brokerage, but you remember, you're running your own business. So just as an example, a lot of times you'll go out and take people out for showings. Either A, they'll ride with you, or B, you'll have them follow behind, however you prefer to do it. If they ride with you, your insurance premium may go up. You have to pay a little bit more to also have your brokerage as an additional insurer on your insurance. So you got to keep those things in mind. In addition to that, when purchasing a vehicle, you have to make sure that it makes sense. So this particular vehicle that I drive is a BMW X5. It's over 6,000 pounds. But the reason that I purchased this vehicle is, yes, it's utility and it is roomy. But if you purchase a vehicle over 6,000 pounds, then the US government will give you great tax incentives and tax write-offs that you can take advantage of. Now, I also know agents that, you know, they want a nicer car, especially when they're showing up to listings or working with clients. They want to show up in a nice luxury vehicle, which is great. Now, in some cases, instead of doing an outright purchase, some people will do a lease. Now, a lease can make it so it's more affordable, where you get a nicer car, but you're paying a lower monthly payment. Now, there are some things to be cautious of. If you do get a lease, remember, it's not your vehicle. You don't own it. You're only leasing it. You're borrowing it for a limited amount of time. Now, your monthly payments may be a little lower than if you owned it, but remember, there's penalties if you go over the allowed mileage that they provide you. So in some cases, they'll say, listen, this is a 3-year lease. All you got to do is give us $2,000 or $5,000 down cash, and then this vehicle can be yours for $369 a month. When in reality, if you bought it, you'd be paying maybe $450 a month. Now, they say for the 3 years, we're gonna give you 13,000 miles each year. But the problem is, if you go over the mileage, we're gonna penalize you, and those penalties come in very heavy, hefty fees. Also, for any dings or any scratches or any damage to the vehicle by the time you bring it back, it will count against you. So then it just becomes a little bit of a money pit if you don't manage your vehicle, manage your mileage, and make sure that you take very, very good care of it. So in this instance, I made a purchase. But when I made the purchase, I purchased it under an LLC. So what I did is I opened an LLC in my name, and then what I did was I purchased the vehicle, put it into the LLC, and then I am using this vehicle as a tax write-off. It's a tax loophole, so I'll take advantage of that whenever I possibly can. But remember, you're running a business. So when you're making purchases, be wise. Make sure that you can take advantage of anything that's set up to help you or help your business and help you save money in the long run. Now, a lot of agents, even if you just have a normal car that you drive for real estate, whenever you're out doing showings or driving around with customers or doing anything that's related to your business, Uncle Sam will allow you to deduct a certain amount of money per mile. So it changes every year, but you know, in some cases, I forget what it is. That's why I have a CPA, an accountant, to do all this for me. But I think it's you get 46 or 50 cents per mile that you can deduct. So what you want to do is you want to have either an app. There's great apps that you can download to track your mileage. Or you can have a little booklet that you keep track of, like, okay, meeting customer on this day, and then you track your miles. Okay, right now I'm at 17,200 miles, and by the time you're done with your day, you'll track how much many miles you traveled. So then at the end of the year, when you do your taxes, your account's gonna say, how many miles did you drive? And you'll say, well, I drove approximately 14,000 miles with work. So then they're gonna say, well, you get 46 cents or 50 cents for each mile that you drove. So then you add it up and you're like, wow, that's a huge savings that I can write off against my taxes, which is huge. You're an independent contractor. You get those deductions. Now, if you're writing off your mileage, you're not allowed to write off maintenance or repairs. So if I'm changing oil or getting my car fixed or having to pay to get it maintained, I can't write off those expenses if I'm writing off my mileage. But if my car is always breaking down, I'm spending tons of money getting it fixed, oil changes, tire changes, repairs, then maybe I'll use those deductions for that year. But remember, be smart, take advantage of what's out there for you, because at the end of the day, we earn a lot of money in our business, and if we're gonna have to pay our full tax rate on the full amount with no deductions, it's gonna hurt your pocket. Remember, your cell phone, this can be an entire deduction. What some people do is they'll get a cell phone and they'll use it only for their business. Otherwise, Uncle Sam's gonna say, well, do you make any private phone calls on this phone, or is it all business? So I prefer you just get a phone, it's all business, therefore you can deduct your entire cell phone bill. If you use a home office, so if you work out of home, or even if you have an office at your office. So sometimes you'll work at a real estate company and the broker will rent you out an office space. Say you pay $200 a month for that office space. Well, the way that it works is when you do your taxes, you could tell your tax accountant, hey, you know what? I pay $200 a month for this office. And they'll say, great, we'll write off the entire thing because it's for business. Or if I have a home office and my mortgage is $3,400 a month, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the amount of my mortgage and I'm gonna divide it by the square footage of my house. And then if that room that I work out of is my office is 200 square feet, I'm gonna take that 200 square feet and multiply it by the amount of my mortgage, and then I'll be able to deduct a portion of my mortgage payments for that home office. In addition to that, let's see here, sorry. I'm just getting gas right now. This is what made me think of it, because now I'm getting gas, and gas is an expense. So, do I write off gas? Do I write off mileage? So it all adds up. So anytime that you do get gas, make sure you save your receipt, and then you track what, when, and how, and what was for. Or, like I said, if you're not stuck in the Stone Age, there's these awesome apps that track everything for you. Your gas, your mileage, all that. So, at the end of the day, if you're not familiar with how this stuff works, I personally, as a broker, will have CPAs and accountants come to the office, and I give classes to my agents to let them know how they could take advantage of these tax loopholes or these programs that are set out for independent contractors. But if your broker's not providing that for you, then what I recommend is you get educated on your own. And if you're doing your own taxes on TurboTax, I don't recommend it. So get an accountant, get a CPA, get somebody who can see how much money you're making, what you're spending, how it all works. In fact, I'll show you guys right now. So each of these cards here that I have in my wallet represents a different business or a different account that I have for a different type of business. So anytime that I make a purchase, I strictly use that card for that business and that purchase. So I could track all my expenses for that particular business. I could print out any statements or anything like that, provide it to my accountant. I say, write it all off. It's all a business expense. On top of that, and of course, your CPA or your accountant's gonna know what they can and cannot do within the scope of the law. So if you think one thing, they're gonna say, well, listen, I could write off most of this stuff, but this, I won't be able to write off because that's not technically a business expense. But for instance, whenever I pay my realtor dues or I renew my license, where I take continuing education classes, those are thousands of dollars that I can write off as a tax deduction. On top of that, if I've got to travel for business or if I go take a news conference that I go somewhere for to educate myself or to grow myself as an individual with my business specifically, I can write off the trip, write off the plane ticket, all that good stuff. Because why? Well, because it's for my business. So remember, work smart, not hard. And if you're spending money on your business, but you're not using these valuable deductions, it's either A, because nobody ever taught you, B, you don't have an accountant or CPA that's managing your income and handling your taxes appropriately, and last but not least, maybe that's why I'm here. If you watch a video like this, you'll know exactly how it works. Now, on top of that, I also have another credit card that earns me cash back. So whenever I use this card for my business, these are large business purchases. In fact, the other day I bought some office furniture. With one purchase, I put about $6,000 on this card with one purchase. But guess what? I got 1.5% cash back on all my purchases. Can you blur that out later? What happens is I get 1.5% cash back anytime I make a purchase. So not only am I spending $6,000, but I also just made 1.5% of that back as cash, which I can apply towards more purchases, Amazon shopping, or I could just apply it back towards my bill when I pay this. But you want to get a good credit card that returns some value back into your pocket. But at the end of the day, I could go on and on and on. Just be smart. And remember, take advantage of the tax programs that are out there for you.